Listen, this is Taskmaster. At its heart, Taskmaster is a warm show which shines a playful light on the strengths and weaknesses of our comedian friends. Ultimately, it's just feel-good fun that celebrates what it is to be human, what it is to be fallible. That's the introduction that Channel 4 signed off. This is what I was going to go with. Come and laugh at the stupid clowns. They can't do anything. Laugh at them. Make them feel sorry for being bad at things. Drive them from their homes. Form an angry mob and drive them from their actual homes. Here they are now. Please welcome Ardal. Next to me, a man who bravely confided in me recently that he doesn't think the NHS is very good and that some nurses are lazy. It's a little Alex Hall!
All right.
I see, from one glance, that you've taken my criticisms of this banter section to heart.
Yes, I've made an effort. I've put my gloves on, taking it seriously. Got one, got the other. Here we are.
Everything all right with this hand?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, I've got another arm! I've got another arm! Yeah.
Do it again.
Oh!
I'm sort of annoyed it is quite funny. Would you please tell me what the prize category is?
I would like to do that, Mr. Handsome. Today they've been asked to bring in the most surprising thing from their wardrobes. Yes, Greg will graciously bestow 5 points upon the person who's brought in the most surprising thing, and then the person who wins the episode will take home 5 things that'll make their wardrobe even more surprising than the one that had the lion, the witch and the wardrobe, but not the wardrobe in it.
Yes, stick to the false hand thing, probably. Right, Chris, you're up first. What did you bring in?
A wetsuit.
OK, here it is.
And that's surprising...
..'cos I've never used it.
I, too, have got a wetsuit, so you might be surprised to learn. Yes. I look over 9 months pregnant. Chris, I've got to be honest, I'm not that surprised you've got a wetsuit.
Really?
Hey, you're a young, strapping lad. I would expect you to be jumping in and out.
I've never been in water with it.
Why did you buy it?
I saw someone paddle... I drove over a bridge and I saw someone paddleboarding and I went, I'll do that, and I bought all the gear and I couldn't get it on and I got frightened and I never did it.
Chris, I think you're doing yourself down. A, out of points, and B... and B, out of your capacity to be a water baby. I think you'd be delightful. Ardal. More surprising than a wetsuit?
Yeah, I think it is, actually. I brought a red leather jacket that's very squeaky.
Here is a squeaky red leather jacket.
Is it your red leather jacket?
It is. I bought it about 10 years ago.
I am quite surprised. Have you ever worn it out, Ardal?
No, no! I've never even tried it on.
I mean, it's an act of madness is what it is.
Yeah, and at the time, I didn't know it squeaked. And I really don't like squeaky clothes.
That is famous for that.
Someday I'm going to get to wear it. I mean, if I'm elected mayor...
Why don't you wear it for the finale of this series? Good, Ardal. Quite surprising. Sophie, surprise me.
I brought in biscuits.
Biscuits.
This is hard for me to say. I don't own a wardrobe. Some of us are struggling. I'm struggling to buy... So I moved into my room, it was unfurnished.
Right, and you can't afford a wardrobe?
I can now afford a wardrobe, but I haven't yet made the purchase. I'm a millennial, we don't rush into... I've had to buy a lot of brunch, I haven't...
If you don't have a wardrobe, where did you get these biscuits out of? Because I think you may have misunderstood the task.
OK, so I don't have a wardrobe, but I have a sort of, like, drawer?
Like
a
drawer?
Window seat. Like, OK, so you, like, you know when you're in a room and you're like, oh, there's no storage in here.
A chest.
And then you're... No, it's not a chest, it's built into the window.
Oh, my God, I'm so bored.
For someone who's struggling, they look like very expensive
biscuits. They are expensive biscuits! Yeah. You're surprised that there are nice biscuits in my fascinating...
I'm surprised, but not for the right reasons.
Two left.
Judi.
In my wardrobe, my surprising thing was a nurse's outfit. You know, the thing is, obviously, I do videos and all kinds of stuff, so...
What do you mean? Just to be clear, cos Alex is quite naive.
No, like, sometimes I dress up in my, you know, little outfit and I play to myself and look in a mirror and pump and save someone's life in my imagination and, you know, create this whole world of ER and all those kind of places.
It's like she's speaking in tongues, isn't it?
I mean, you'd want to come and play. Honestly, it's a beautiful...
Bridget, can you beat Judy's surprising nurse outfit?
Well, I have brought in an antique Japanese kimono. I bought it specifically for you about 17 years ago. I saw it in a charity shop window and I thought there's only one person I know who's big enough to wear that. So I looked it up. It's actually worth thousands of pounds. I didn't realise. And I think if you wore this beautiful piece...
Yeah. You've had multiple opportunities to find me and give me my gift.
You tell me... You tell me, then, when I could have given you this.
At any point in the last 17 years.
Oh,
I'm not the Scarlet Pimpernel.
Oh,
I live in London.
Me.
I put it to you.
No, I put it to you.
I put it to you.
Not only do I put it to
you... I put it back to you. You bought that kimono, not realising it was expensive. You were going to give it to me, then you found out it was worth something, and you kept it for yourself!
So you're not surprised that I got you a kimono? I cannot believe
it. No, I am surprised. I'm more surprised that you haven't given it to me. So you're sort of getting big surprise points for the wrong reasons.
Well, it didn't say in the task, surprise him for the right reason.
True again?
Sure. Makes a good point.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, do you want to hand out some points?
Yes, I do. I'm sorry, Chris, I must give you 1 point.
OK, 1 point to Chris Ramsey.
Oh.
You can thank me for your 2 points, for your weird biscuits.
Two to Sophie.
I'm not that surprised you've got a nurse's outfit. You and I can talk that out later.
OK, Three points. You hear that? Did you hear that, yes?
I am desperate to see you in that red jacket. I'm going to give it 4 points. And I think this is a hollow victory because you surprised me for the wrong reasons. And nonetheless, I'm surprised, so I'll give you the 5.
There we go. 5 points.
There it is.
5 points to Bridget Christie!
I'd like to have a new task, please.
OK, well, we have a little taster of a task, first of all. An hors d'oeuvre or a canapé, a tidbit to get the juices flowing, an appetizer, perhaps, or an aperitif.
Do you want to shut up?
Hello, Alex. Something moving in there.
Make this key difficult but possible to retrieve.
You have 10 minutes.
Your time starts now.
Well, who's retrieving it?
Who do you think's going to retrieve it?
Well, I don't think you'd pay for animals to come and retrieve it because they're expensive.
Is it difficult for someone else to retrieve or difficult for me to get it back?
All the information's on the task.
There's no more information.
I'd like to go outside.
You'd like to go outside?
I think so.
OK.
I mean, I could swallow it, but that wouldn't be much fun for anyone.
It would be fun for quite a lot of us.
The retrieving part wouldn't be much fun for you.
That's true.
Trust me.
Oh, that was difficult.
How difficult is it to retrieve it?
It's difficult. If you're short, you have a go.
I don't know what that is. Can I have that?
Yeah?
That's the key. Thank you.
Are you going up at your... Yeah. Well, I know where it went and I can't retrieve it.
But you reckon it's possible?
I reckon it's possible.
I'm just gonna...
Where's the key?
Oh. It was in my mouth.
Key is in the tree.
So it's in a basket, in a tree, and it's wet.
It's covered in my spit.
Tick.
Yeah.
But was it difficult to...
But possible.
Is that it?
That is going in there.
So that key is now difficult but possible to retrieve.
I would, yeah.
Judy, you were asked to make it difficult to retrieve.
Yeah, but you guys muddled
up. Both occasions just popped it somewhere.
But the last one is difficult.
Then you came good.
Just what I'm saying, try once, try
twice.
It's
quite a contrast seeing Sophie clamber up a tree and then cover the key in flob. Chris, I appreciated yours. Nice, simple system. Tie the key to something, hoy it up a tree. Thank you. Ardal, what do you do with yours?
I put it in a tree.
Oh, yeah, you hoyed it in a tree as well. Yeah. A lot of people hoyed it up a tree. Good.
Let's crack on. Yeah. Well, look, we'll find out later on how they've done. That's only half the task. But now it's time for five. And that is a high five.
Okay.
Lovely.
Here we all are.
Number three.
Number three, yes. And now you can open the task.
Oh. Chris, you go. You go for it this time.
Give Alex a high five.
The third fastest high fiver wins.
If you're the first or the last, you will receive no points.
You must high five Alex in the next 10 minutes.
Your time starts now. You're not a team anymore. For this one, there is only one winner out of the five of you.
Oh.
And that's the person who high-fives me third.
Did you understand the task?
No.
Sophie, did you understand?
I understood the task.
Yeah?
You did?
Yeah.
Really?
Can you just explain it?
So it was, you had to be third to do the high-five.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, look, should we let her process it for a little bit longer and see the boys first?
Yeah, let's do that.
OK. I should explain, first of all, they came separately as teams to do this, and we've comped them together with the magic of television.
Amazing. Yeah. Amazing.
Yeah. It was amazing.
All right, well, first, to give me a bit of skin, it's the boys. Here we go.
So someone's done it first, someone will do it last. They don't get any points.
And you want to be third?
All that we will know is who goes first between us.
Yeah. So nobody is realistically going to make a move before 9 minutes have gone.
Or did someone do it straight away? Oh, this is horrible.
OK, so who's going to jump the gun? Judi is going to do it straight away. She's going to be first.
You think?
Yeah.
Chris, are you thinking you want to do it before Ardal or after Ardal?
While he's thinking.
Wow! OK. So, I could either be guaranteed second here or guaranteed last.
You're definitely not going to be the first, Chris.
Shut up.
Good high five.
OK.
Can I have another go?
I mean, if you went again, there is a chance you'd be third.
A slight chance.
I can never be third, can I?
Yeah.
So you can't come last now, Chris?
No.
Or first?
No.
So you've got a point.
You've done me a real favour there, mate. Thank you.
So I'm first, third and last. And second. Yeah. No, I'm not second.
You could be second.
I could be first, second, third, fourth and last.
Yeah.
I've covered all the bases. I can do no more than that. I'm just going to just go one more time, just in case.
Well, that's your third high-five, Ardal.
Yeah. And you know what? Because I have no idea what's going on. There we go.
Right.
There's just no way I can lose.
You were very greedy there, Ardal.
I was a bit.
You were very greedy.
Ardal, can I ask why you thought I would be first?
I thought you'd be first. Well, yeah. I think you're first amongst women. I mean...
Ooh.
We break because we must. Just time for your partner to clip their toenails in front of you and for you to wonder where the mystery's gone. See you in a bit!
Yes. The second best part. There was a sort of team task going on before the break. In their separate groups, they're trying to work out when best to high-five me to become the third high-fiver out of all five competitors. Tricky. The first and last to high-five me get no points at all. There's a 10-minute cap, and just to drill it in, the third high-fiver wins. Next up, it's the girls with some unorthodox approaches.
We could all tactically work together.
No, we can't, cos we can't all be third.
Yeah, you're not a team anymore.
We're not a team.
Not for this task.
Sorry.
OK.
Well, I just took the risk.
Well, you still might be the third fastest.
Well, at least you know the first and the fifth won't win, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, you've both got a chance. How many minutes had gone until I... when I...
No minutes. About no. 20 seconds.
No? Really?
Mm-hmm.
No, it... Oh. 20 seconds? No, seriously, it was about a minute, though, wasn't it? A minute in. It was a minute in. Oh, man!
Yeah, but you still don't know if you would have...
No!
No, I think she's...
I think I should... Oh, my... I really sacrificed myself. I should have done it.
I need to do it now.
They might not go.
No, they got. No, I'm doing it.
Oh, that's a great high five. We've had at least two high fives now.
Yeah, well, they've both gone now, so
yeah.
I can do whatever I want.
So you'll either be third, fourth, or fifth, Bridget.
Bridget, I think you should go. You are.
I want to do it at 10.
You want to do it at 10? Okay.
No, I'm going to do it at 9:59, and I'm going to run.
You can't wait, babes. You've got to go and high five him. What are you waiting for? The third fastest.
It might not be the third one who does it. It's the period between here and there, isn't it?
What?
That's how you're interpreting it, is it? Right.
10.
Well, I didn't predict it would go like that. You may now leave.
After you, Queen.
Bye.
That was really stressful.
Wow. There was a confidence to you, Sophie, that I don't really understand. You seem to have absolute faith in your system.
Yeah. I think my confidence was bolstered by the fact that Judi just went for it.
That would have helped.
Look, at the end of the day... I want you to not just be the third, but I want you to be the fastest third.
Yeah. Bridget, you also did not understand the task.
Absolutely. You keep offending me. So I thought that it would be very exciting to high-five on zero, and it was. And also... I thought that by sacrificing myself, you would think that that was quite a dignified thing to do and give me 1 point.
Incorrectly.
All right, shall I show you how it all played out, Craig?
Please.
OK.
Your time starts now.
That was the first of the high fives.
Okay. So if we can leave it long enough to think they may not have done it yet.
They might have not gone. They might not go.
No, they got. No, I'm doing it.
Oh, that's a great high five.
I'm gonna go when it hits 3 minutes.
No way I can lose.
Oh,
Look at Alex's face! Can I just say, I didn't know what the hell was going on.
I feel good.
So we know categorically that Judi went first, so doesn't get any points at all.
Correct.
We also know that Sophie went third, so gets 5 points. So well done, Sophie. Congratulations. We also know that Ardal did it second, fifth, sixth, and seventh.
Yep.
But the person who went last didn't get points. Did he do it last, or did Bridget do it last? Because she didn't do it at all within the time.
I'm not going to penalise Ardal.
Well, there we go. 5 points to Sophie, 4 to Chris, and 4 to Ardal, and that's it.
Can I see how the scores are looking, please?
Yes, you can. Well, with those 4 points, Ardal moves into first place with 8 points. Judy's on 3.
Lovely.
You will give me another task.
Yes, I will. And we've gone big budget at last, because this one involves tanks.
Hello.
Hi, Sophie.
Hi. Oh, listen,
there's a tub of water next to me. This shit ain't getting wet, OK? I need you to know that.
OK.
OK.
That Greek statue? Looks very like you. One big ball down there by your leg. Mm-hmm. Mm.
Make the water level rise to the top of the big fish tank.
You have 15 minutes to gather 6 things, then you must put all 6 things in the big fish tank.
Why do you keep saying big? Oh, because there's another one.
You may not put anything in the big fish tank before the 15 minutes are up, and if any water leaves the big fish tank at any point, you are disqualified.
But it has to be 6 things, nor less. Can't be 5, can't be 7.
So I have to gather the things.
You can wait till they come to you, but I would go.
You may not put anything in the big fish tank before the 15 minutes are up.
Closest water level to the top of the big fish tank wins. No fish tanks may leave this room. Your time starts now.
Are you saying that I must make the water rise?
You've got to make the water rise when you put the things in.
So what am I doing with this?
That's up to you.
It's like water displacement, isn't it?
Yes, I thought it was quite a simple task about water displacement.
I thought it was a very simple task, but it seemed to absolutely baffle everyone. Right, should we crack on?
Let's crack on. Remember, no fish tank can leave the room. So let's begin with two people who are great at reading and remembering things. It's Bridget and Sophie.
No fish tanks may leave this room. They've put a little joke in there. OK. This is my test tank. You can't take them out of this room, which I think is a silly sentence to put in there, to be honest with you. It's a test tank, but yeah, it's a test tank. Well, can I put some water in there then?
All the information is on that tank.
Oh my God, he just keeps repeating himself. Is that what you do at home? God, I'm terrible. Yes, so I'm going to. I'm going to take my lolly as well.
So what wasn't shown in that clip is that I did realise that I wasn't made to take the tank out and I nearly had a nervous breakdown.
She did.
And I said, I'm going to make this right. And I said to Alex, I said, will the Taskmaster forgive me if I made it right?
Bridget.
Indefensible, I've got nothing to say. Rubbish.
Mm. Oh, really? Oh, let me bait you anyway. What I wrote down was, I've said it before and I'll say it again,
yeah,
but I really think this show is ruining your reputation as someone with a brain in their nut.
It was sort of rude and not funny either.
Right, let's crack on.
OK, well, now it's for my hero. Sorry, the star of My Hero. It's Ardal O'Hanlon.
Hi, Ardal.
Hi. Start with this. Yeah.
Have you finished putting that in?
Yeah, the mallet's in now. That's exactly what I wanted to happen there. The statue has gone in. The satsumas. And they're doing exactly what I wanted them to do as well. And now I'm going to put a quantity of water in.
Can you be more specific?
No, I don't have to be. So that's a portion of the quantity. You know, I'm going to leave it there.
I don't know if that was six items.
Well, will I allow a quantity of water, I guess, is going to be the debate, isn't
it? He argued it was brick satsuma, mallet, statue satsuma and water. Those were his six things. So satsuma's twice, water's once, but there was...
And I did feel a little bit smug. I mean, that was the only... Like, if there's marks been deducted for smugness, I will accept that.
Well, if you put smugness in as well, that's seven items.
Yeah. I'm going to allow his quantity of water.
Yeah, you don't put waters in, do you? You put water in.
Yeah.
You may have won the task, but you've lost some friends.
There is that. It's a sacrifice I'm prepared to make.
Right. Don't channel hop. We've got a space laser trained on your home. See you in a bit. Little Alex Horn, can you please remind Judi what was going on before the break?
Yes, of course. Hi, Judi.
Hello.
I don't know if you remember, but we were in the middle of the task where you all had to try and raise the level of the water in a fish tank by putting six items in it closest to the top wins, Judi. Mm-hmm. We've grouped you in with Chris. Chris is a nice young man sat next to you. Oh. And I'm going to show you your VT right now. Here we go.
I'm scared because this seems really simple.
What do you think you're going to do?
In a perfect world, you'd have one, two, like six Bibles.
I just want to see.
What a scientific approach.
Whoa, there's a lot of similar shapes here. I think five playing cards in that.
When I go in the bath, it comes up. I need something heavy, something heavy.
That's not a real bookshelf. That would have helped.
Will this fit in the tank? That's gonna float.
That's gonna float. That's gonna float in there.
That works a little bit.
Why was that there?
Right.
I've made my pick.
Right, let's do it. One is the case. Two, three, four, five, six. I'm gonna go for it and put them in there.
Floating like two dicks. Why is it floating? That didn't happen when it was in there. What's in this water? Oh, you've set me up.
Okay. Some water came out straight away. How was that not heavy enough?
Okay. Come on, girl. We're a gulper. I think that's the best.
Finished?
Yeah.
Whew. Thanks, Judi.
You both had very strong instant impulses. Yours was, this is easy, I just need six Bibles. Have you put Bibles in water before to raise water levels?
No.
No? And you did exactly the same. Straight out the room, get a small amount of water and a loaf of bread, put that in there.
Yes.
Obviously, Judy's gone straight into the Taskmaster Book of Quotes by saying of a bunch of bananas, it's floating like two dicks.
In the bathroom and your partner's
me
in
personally
there. Well, no, someone's partner, if you've got a partner and you walked in and he's in the bathroom having a whale of a time relaxing, and then you just see no no
yeah
Yeah. Who hasn't seen their willy float up to the theme from Jaws? She's right.
He ended up doing pretty well, 1.8 centimetres from the top. Oh. Although I should say Chris got very close to discovering the actual right way to do it. Can I show you this?
Oh.
Why was that there? Right.
So, points.
Yes. Judi does get 4 points with her 18 millimetres, but Ardal gets 5 points with his water system. Well done, Ardal.
Well done, Ardal. The rest, zero.
Yes. No points to anyone else.
Never mind. Let's have another one.
Right. I have a task ready, and this one might explain why nobody ever takes my phone calls.
Hello?
65.
62.
Is there a reason why I've got this bushy thing in my face? Yeah?
That's about 51.
Short staffed?
61.
Answer Alex's phone call.
If you find a cuddly toy, you must carry it with you until you answer Alex's phone call.
Also, you must be making a noise over 50 decibels for at least 50% of the time.
Until you... What, 62?
Yeah, 62 again.
Until you answer Alex's phone.
Fastest wins. Your time starts now.
I'm just keeping an eye on your sound.
And I've got to hear the phone.
Yeah, can you hear a phone?
I don't know.
I want to hear some noise.
Oh, you want to hear some noise? What kind of noise do I need to make?
Whatever
any
you want.
Noise?
Anything over 50.
Any noise at all. Any noise at all.
Lovely.
Lovely.
I don't think there's much to discuss.
Let's crack on.
Let's crack on.
All right, three of them up first. Ardal, Judi and Chris, all trying to answer the phone the fastest for you. Greg Davis, the Taskmaster. Let's go.
OK.
You're being very quiet at the moment.
What?
You're being very quiet.
Oh, sorry, yes.
No, but I'm calling it. Why are you chasing me?
I want to answer your phone.
No, but let's do the phone I'm calling with. You can't answer the same phone that someone's calling.
Oh, sorry.
I don't know what that noise is. Come on. Where are we going? No, is it this way? Is this it?
I need 50%
of... Come on, more. What?
Yeah, yeah, just for 50%
of
the time.
Yeah.
Where's the phone? No, here's a cuddly toy.
Yeah, you're not supposed to be looking for them.
Where's the phone?
Stop! Is that it?
Have you answered the phone?
Is it a phone?
It's a tape!
Oh no.
Okay, might be outside. Let's go. That's not a phone, that's a... Wait, these are so old!
Now just remember I've left the teddy bear.
Come back, quick, come on! Keep going!
Oh.
Greg!
Ah, no, you need me to be calling.
There's a decoy as well.
At least you've got another cuddly toy. Ah!
Have you got the phone on you? Give me the phone.
I don't have the phone.
So where's the phone? Where's the damn phone?
I feel like I've looked everywhere. I'm scared. Is this... Well, there's a phone box here. Ooh. Oh, there it is.
What does it say, Chris? It
says you must not break this box.
I don't have a key. But I suspect I know where the key is.
Where's the key, Ardal?
It's in a not impossible to retrieve place.
Where's the key?
On the bush!
The key's on the bush.
Oh my God! Right.
If you just place it there, that'd be great.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Can you see it?
No.
Where's the key? Where's the key?
Clock's ticking.
You're being very quiet up there.
Hey!
Can you sign?
Yeah, I found the key.
Oh, great.
There it is!
Oh, oh.
Come on!
Hello!
Hi, Judy, it's Alex here. I'm gonna stop the clock.
I've got some stuff in my mouth. Stick, stick. Get on the stick, you prick. Get on the stick, you prick, you prick. Get on the stick.
No?
I've stopped the clock.
Thank you, Alex.
Is that you, Chris?
Yes.
I'm gonna stop the clock.
Thank you.
Beat that, Annika Rice!
She's not in this series.
OK. No.
Yeah, Annika, beat that. I enjoyed Get on the Stick, You Prick.
Got to have a catchphrase.
Well, he was also the only one with any real urgency. Ardal was largely committed to being a human bear. And Judy was wandering around as if she was just a market browser.
Yes. Yeah. Well, out of the three of them, she was the slowest, I'm afraid. She was 60.
Who? Who was the slowest?
Judy Love.
Who was the fastest, Chris?
Out of these three, no, it was Ardal O'Hanlon, 10 minutes 12.
Too distracted by the crazy bear. Well done. It's the end of part three. Come back soon to the only show on television where you might see Sophie Duker win a giant kimono for a wardrobe that doesn't exist. For coming back to me. There's a task hanging in the balance. Alex, please bring us up to speed so that we can finish this thing.
Right you are. They are trying to answer a call from me, but the phone is hidden. There are lots of decoy phones to annoy them, and when they do find the right phone, it's in a locked box, and the key is in a difficult but possible to retrieve place. It's just Bridget and Sophie left. Here we go.
OK, I'm listening. I found a cuddly toy.
Are you coming?
Yes.
OK. Oh, there's the little toy.
It's not ringing.
It's ringing.
No, it's not.
This is where we started, wasn't it?
Yeah, so we're going back, are we?
What are we doing again?
You're trying to answer my phone call. Clock's ticking, Bridget.
Oh, yeah. Are we on the clock?
Yeah.
Hi! I'm just looking...
Stop talking to the camera, people.
Oh.
There's too many toys! I'm gonna carry them here.
Ah.
Yeah.
I suppose so.
Let's go.
You have to answer the phone before everyone else answers the phone.
Yeah, I don't know where the phone is, though.
I can hear something. Oh, no. This is needs a key.
Are they going on an adventure?
Yeah, we're going on an adventure.
If I do this, we won't have to chit-chat.
No, good. OK.
No, that's not ringing. Oh, we're back in here?
Yes.
Gosh, has it been in here all the time?
Can my children wait at the bottom of the tree?
I think they might have to.
I'm a bit sick of going in here.
Me too. Oh, where else might there be a phone?
In the shed? No, I've been in...
Is that Sophie?
Yes, this is me.
I've stopped the clock.
I don't believe it. I've got the key in my boot! Yes, hello?
I've stopped the clock.
If I had got here quicker, then I'd probably have done all right in that task, because I had the key.
Yes.
Well, there was one bit to get a clip of, because I think it's sort of a metaphor for the pointlessness of life.
Just this clip here.
It's what the show does to
it
you.
It does.
I think that's perfect. I think you've nailed it.
It's free. It's probably what led Sophie to climb a tree with a load of cuddly toys down her trousers.
I think I had pandas in my cooch when I climbed that tree. And I was...
That's the first.
Do you mind if I just...
No one's ever said that before.
Panther's in my cooch. Yeah.
You took 19 minutes and 5 seconds altogether.
Wow.
So far in last place, but we haven't heard Bridget's facts yet. 23 minutes and 1 second, so I'm afraid, it's last place. And with that, Bridget gets 1 point, Sophie 2, Judi 3, Chris 4, but the winner again is Ardal O'Hanlon with 5 points.
Let's have a quick look at the series scores.
The series scores, all right. At the bottom of the pile at the moment is Judi with 66, then it's Ardal with 71, but just above, Sophie with 72, Bridget 79, Chris on 80, so it's pretty tight at this stage.
Tight at the top. All right, everyone, please make your way to the stage for the final task of the show! Well, no need to explain. I think we know what's going on here. Who's going to read the task out, silly boy?
I would like Bridget Christie to read the task, please, Greg.
Right. Pop 3 red balls out of your hole. You may only pop out 1 ball at a time. If you pop out a black ball, you must stop popping out balls and scream for 5 seconds. If you pop out a white ball, everyone must stop popping out balls and dance like a worm for 5 seconds. If you pop out a duck, you are disqualified. Also, you must stare lovingly at the Taskmaster. I'm not doing that bit. You must stare lovingly at the Taskmaster throughout the task. Fastest wins.
Thank you, Bridget. I'll let you know if you have to scream or dance.
Sophie's loving looks quite threatening. You make me blush, Ardal.
Your time starts. And off they go. Off they go.
Lovingly, Judi. Lovingly.
So we've got a black ball. You can keep going. Oh, everyone dance. Everyone dance. Everyone dance. Everyone dance. Off you go again. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Keep looking at the top. Judi is out. Judi has popped a duck. Scream! Ah! Everyone dance, please. There's a white one. Everyone dance. Everyone dance, please. Everyone dance. Except for Judi, who's disqualified.
What am I disqualified?
Because you popped out a duck.
It's not you.
OK, carry on. Get some red balls, please. Everyone dance, please. There's a white ball. Everyone dance. How are we doing? Everyone all right?
Judy's furious because she popped the duck.
Scream, please, Ardal. Scream, please, Bridget. Everyone down. Everyone down.
One ball.
Dance and scream. Carry on. It's a red one for Bridget. That's lovely. It's a red
one. Thank God. Thank God.
A red one for Sophie. There's not a red one there. We've got two red
balls for Chris.
Scream, please, Ardal. Scream. It's just one red to come. One pop. Look at the Taskmaster lovingly, please.
Lovingly. Oh! Perfectly reasonable. We'll add that up. We'll add it to the final score. Come and join me.
A lot of fun.
A lot of fun.
Everyone really enjoy that?
No.
No.
Do you want to give Judi a point or not? She was disqualified.
Yeah, well, let's not be monstrous.
We'll give her a point.
Got a point.
Ooh. Got your duck out, just stood there looking angry.
But that's Oh, sorry, did you?
Sorry, I was just having a little chuckle.
Ardal should be chuckling because the scoreboard is extraordinary. Bridget, Chris, and Judy all have 11, Sophie 13, but Ardal's got 21 points. Ardal Hanlon is the winner.
Please go and scoop up your surprising wardrobe star. What have we learnt today? We've learnt that life can be brutal, but no matter who's upset you, how crushed you are by disappointment, what hurdles you have to try and overcome, things could always be worse. That is half of this series done. Well done you, but well done mainly to tonight's winner, Ardal Hanlon!